This time on Filmwrecker, we are looking at John Singleton. Singleton made 9 films over his almost 30 years as a director, including critically acclaimed classics, cult favorites, and fast-paced action blockbusters, almost all of which deal with heavy themes such as racism, inequality, and the impact of violence. So let's take a look at a stellar career and count them down. Number 9, Abduction. We all make mistakes, and unfortunately for John Singleton, that was agreeing to direct a film starring Twilight's Taylor Lautner. It's not that Singleton does a bad job. He does all that he possibly can with what he's got to work with, but what he has to work with is an epic mess of a script and actors who understandably don't buy into anything that they are doing or saying. Number 8. Too Fast, Too Furious. I feel like this one needs a caveat because none of the Fast and Furious movies are really great movies, but they're not meant to be. And even this one, which most agree to be the worst of the series, still has a lot of bright colored cars, silly but fun dialogue, and very cool races. It also has Tyrese Gibson, who doesn't quite fit into that Vin Diesel-shaped hole, and a bunch of Brian still being unsure about what side he's on. Spoiler alert, he is with Team Street Racer, like he always is. It's not a great movie, but it's Fast and Furious. Number 7, Baby Boy. Baby Boy has some interesting things to say, and it succeeds in saying them, at times flipping the genre on its head. It also features strong supporting performances by Taraji P. Henson and Ving Rhames, as well as a few very memorable scenes, such as Cuba Gooding Jr.'s little brother Omar teaching Tyrese how to punch. It has a style that would perhaps be more confident on the stage than the screen, which is a double-edged sword, as it's packed to the brim with monologues that get a little bit repetitive at times, and the film does occasionally devolve into one large argument, but the style also gives it more weight. At the center of the film is Tyrese Gibson, who does a good job, but doesn't quite pull off the delicate balancing act of remaining a relatable protagonist while still being self-centered enough to fit Singleton's thesis. It's not perfect, but it's worth a watch. Number 6, Higher Learning. Singleton dives into university life in his third film, putting his focus on young students finding themselves while using the college campus as a representation of race relations in America. It is a big film that unflinchingly asks big questions, and it does find some impactful answers. But it does sometimes get a little bit caught up in its ambitions, as some of the sprawling cast of characters and intersecting storylines occasionally get lost in the shuffle. That said, the young cast that includes Omar Epps, Christy Swanson, Ice Cube, Michael Rapaport, Busta Rhymes, and Jennifer Connelly, amongst others, all bring it. And the soundtrack hits that 90s college-style nail right on the head. Number 5, Four Brothers. A bit of a different take on the classic revenge formula. Four Brothers may not have a lot to say, but it is a lot of fun to watch. It feels like Singleton is having fun with this, with the most comedy of any of his films, as well as some truly remarkable scenes. The snow car chase, the gunfight in the street, the ice fields at the end. The secret sauce, however, is in the supporting cast that all seem way too big for their roles. Actors like Taraji P. Henson, Sofia Vergara, Terrence Howard, and Chiwetel Ejiofor, who doesn't just steal scenes, he steals the whole movie as the big bad. Things do get maybe a bit too far-fetched near the end, and the titular brothers don't always carry the show as well as the stellar supports, but this movie is always fun to watch. Number 4, Poetic Justice. John Singleton's second film is a modern take on the classic road movie. It starts a little bit unfocused, but once the mail truck gets out of L.A., it really finds its feet, thanks in large part to surprisingly excellent performances from Janet Jackson and Tupac Shakur, especially Shakur, who is the gravitational center of every frame he is in. At its heart, this movie is a slow-burning and really realistic version of the boy-meets-girl love story. It doesn't feel forced for even a second. It had a little bit of a tough time finding its audience, but that's mostly because it takes big chances and it defies expectations. Number 3, Shaft. 2000 kind of remake, kind of sequel to the classic Shaft series lived up to most people's expectations. Samuel L. Jackson is the obvious choice to play the lead, though it does help that Richard Roundtree shows up to pass the torch. Christian Bale's also the perfect choice for the spoiled rich kid villain. At times, it falls a little bit into the generic detective territory, but between Singleton's direction and a scene-stealing performance from Jeffrey Wright, it always stays a cut above. Number 2. Rosewood. A fictionalized retelling of the 1923 Rosewood Massacre, one of a sadly large number of similar racially fueled events in American history. It is the most beautiful film on Singleton's resume, though sadly, that attention to detail only makes the horror at its center hit harder. It is a harrowing period piece, packed with fantastic performances from people like Don Cheadle, Ving Rhames, and John Voight. It does not hold back an inch, which can make it tough to watch at times, but also propels it above many of its peers. It was sadly overlooked when it was released, but it deserves a much bigger audience. Number 1, Boys in the Hood. John Singleton came on the scene with one heck of a splash. At only 24 years old, he became the youngest director and the first black director ever nominated for an Academy Award. His Boys in the Hood made a lasting impact on film. It helped create a genre of films and opened doors for a generation of new filmmakers. The script is so smart, a slice of life that feels lived in and natural, but it's also jam-packed with memorable lines. The characters pop off the screen, the actors blow the roof off from top to bottom, especially Lawrence Fishburne, all of which makes the climax and the ensuing fallout even more effective. Boys in the Hood is one of a handful of milestone films that changed the movie industry both on screen and off. And that is it. Let me know what you think. And if you missed any of these, especially those ones in the top 5, I strongly suggest finding them and giving them a watch. Also, please like and subscribe, and hopefully, I will see you all next time.